Welcome to Midtown Concerts. My name is Gene Morrow. I'm the executive director of Gotham Early Music Scene, the producer of this series of free weekly concerts. I have bad news and great news. The bad news is that a member of our regularly scheduled duo for this afternoon contracted COVID and was unable to perform. The great news is that we have an internationally recognized keyboard virtuoso filling in with a wonderful recital. It's Gwendolyn Toth, who you may be interested to know actually started this series about 24 years ago. I think it's a great testament to the depth, resilience, and collegiality of our global early music community that we could get someone of Gwen's stature to fill in literally on a moment's notice. Gwen will be playing a program of 17th century harpsichord masterpieces, and a printed copy of that program is available to you on our website, www.gemsny.org. Thank you for tuning in, and we look forward to this concert of 17th century masterpieces with Gwendolyn Toth. Thank you.
Thank you. thank you all for coming to our concert. I'm glad it's not going to snow until later. That's just another thing we really don't need. So this is a program of 17th century music. Actually, it's all dance music because in the 17th century, it was still a little more serviceable to play that sort of music on the harpsichord. And of course, I'm counting the first piece from 1599 as sort of a almost 17th century piece. So that's a very early Baroque example of a dance that might be more of a Renaissance dance, but in early Baroque variation style. And the rest of the music, we move further on into the 17th century. Now, the interesting thing is that this is a program I designed to play on two antique harpsichords down at the Flint Collection in Delaware. And those harpsichords are actual 17th century harpsichords. And they are a rather small compass. They are basically 3.5, 4-octave harpsichords, including a short bass, short-octave bass, which means that I can show you if you come up afterwards, but that some of the bass notes are moved up onto accidentals so that there's even smaller compass than a chromatic keyboard. But this harpsichord is a 5-octave Italian harpsichord, which is not only, it's more than unusual, it's unheard of. I think it's the only one I know of that it's the only one in New York. It may be the only one in this country, as far as I know. It was kind of an experiment on the part of the builder, and I think he was including a modern organ compass because you actually can have pull-down pedal notes on this harpsichord, but we don't have that today, and it's not the right music for it anyway. So I'm just pointing out that this is all music for a rather small instrument being played on a very large instrument, but it sounds lovely. All right. Thank you.
Well, I'm sure you join me in thanking Gwen for a beautiful program that really we have a special thank you today. This harpsichord, this beautiful and unusual harpsichord, was donated to the Church of the Transfiguration by the rector, Father John's cousin, Anna Hughes in North Carolina. She's in her mid-80s. Today is her birthday. So a little shout out to Ms. Hughes, and thank you for this generous donation. Tomorrow, she undergoes major heart surgery. So I think it's entirely appropriate that a major star of the harpsichord has played this recital on her instrument for her today. We also thank our usual sponsors, the Howard Gilman Foundation, the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs, the New York State Council on the Arts, and of course, as Paul mentioned earlier, all of you who make this possible. So thank you very much. Next week we have a wonderful duo, Jean-Marc Rosendahl, and another venerable and well-known harpsichordist, Andrew Appel, will be playing some marvelous music for gamba and harpsichord. So be sure to come back. We'll see you next Thursday.